Hey, pretty people, welcome back to Back to the Future of the Game. I think this is it. I think this is the last episode that we're going to be doing. Alright, back in 1931, Marty has restored Emmett to the path of science, and as a result, he's been reunited with Emmett's older self, Doc Brown. But the two friends' reunion was interrupted by a disaster, and Strickland inadvertently jumped into the past and caused Hill Valley itself to disappear. Let's go prevent that from happening, shall we? One more trip back in time. From 1986 back to 1876, 110 years into the past. Monday, July 17th, 1876. Alright, saloon sign.
I think I liked it better on the outhouse door.
Beauregard Tannen. Beauregard Tannen?!
I'd better not get too close.
Shit. Pickle barrel.
I'd better not get too close.
I don't have anything that will... recording device. What you said on it?
Not sure what that'll do.
Right. Okay, so let's get out of here. What? But I gotta get that close. Window, rope, window. Okay, click on the window. Easy, Marty. Oh, Jesus Christ, what are you doing, Edna?
Who's there?
Edna, stop. It's just me.
Mr. Sagan, what are you doing here?
I was gonna ask you the same question, Miss Pickford.
Isn't it obvious? I'm putting an end to your den of iniquity before it starts.
I don't think so, Mary. I don't like shooting women, but no one comes between Beauregard V. Tannen and his livelihood.
Tannen, stop! If you shoot her, she'll drop the torch and this whole place will burn up. Edna, stop! If you drop that torch, he'll shoot us!
Oh, looks like we're at something of a standoff here, Mr. Tannen.
I don't see a way out unless somebody manages to disarm both of you at the same time.
How the hell am I supposed to do that?
Well, Marty, I have an idea. Yes.
Pickle juice. That ought to be handy for putting out torches. It's too heavy to lift.
What about the rope? Okay, come on this way. Back behind here.
Man, this thing is not light.
Ladder.
It's right over his head, but I can't knock him out while Edna's still holding that torch.
Mary Pickford?
Don't tell me that you're not traveling through time under a
Come on. Get on the pallet, Marty.
Not quite.
Why are you so hellfire determined to meddle in my affairs, woman? You've been a-burring my behind for over a month now.
You're the source of the hellfire around here, Tannen. I'm just fanning the flames a little.
Lady, I'm just giving the hard-working folk of Hill Valley a place to...
I can't reach it. And even if I could knock it down, Edna'd be free to torch the place.
True. Get over there? I can't go over that way. Okay. To the ladder. Sandbag.
Man, this thing is not light.
Okay. Anything over here that I can... Tacky painting.
Dolores Miskin?
Well, she certainly looks like Trixie Trotter.
The sandbag's right over Tannen's head.
Doc, Edna.
If I don't figure out some way of dousing that flame, Edna's gonna burn down the town. Hang in there, Doc. The sandbag's right over Tannen's head.
Okay, I can't go out that way.
I wonder what's in these. No, stop, quiet! God.
What the hell? Oh, cow crap! There goes all my pickled pig's feet!
Why are you...
Pickle juice. That ought to be handy for putting out torches. It's too heavy to lift.
Okay. I think I should be in the right spot. Here we go. That sandbag is too heavy to lift.
Going down.
Looks like your torch is getting a little dim there, Miss Pickford.
It's still hot enough to bring down this little bit of Gamora, Tannen.
Jeez. Sandbag. Come on. Right there on the pallet.
All right, physics.
Yeah, thank you, physics. Barrel of pickle juice, come on. Why can't... Oh, come on, are you kidding me?
What kind of odds would you give me that I can disarm you and douse the young lady's torch simultaneously?
About the same odds that you can walk out of here without getting a shot to the gut, stranger.
I can't reach it.
Nope, I don't have anything. Shit! Shit, this is hella tricky right now. Rope. No, that's not what I said to do. I said to use a rope. There we go.
What was that noise?
What noise? I didn't hear a noise.
Are you here to haul me back to 1931 for my supposed crimes? Or is there some sort of time court for that kind of thing?
Time court? What in the name of Ulysses S. Grant is she talking about?
How the hell am I supposed to do that? Can't click on that. Shit! Okay. Hey?
Cripes, it's no wonder the town went up. I can smell the kerosene from here.
Edna...
Say, that's a lovely chandelier you've got there, Tannen.
Well, there's a sandbag over Tannen's head. I wonder if I can get something over Edna's torch.
Okay. I know I need to do this. I know basically what I need to do. It's just how. Ladder. Oh, rope.
Not sure why I did that.
Yeah.
Maybe we can come to a more...
Sure why I did that.
A barrel is over there. What can I...
Not sure what that'll do.
Marty, just go across! Marty, why are you doing this to me, man?
A 100 years from now, Hill Valley will erect a statue in my honor.
If you go through with this, there won't be a Hill Valley 100 minutes from now.
Well, there's a sandbag over Tannen's head. I wonder if I can get something over Edna's torch.
What can I get? Okay, let's start hovering over things. Okay. Chandelier, Edna, Doc. Beauregard Tannen, shotgun. Shotgun?
If I had a gun, I could probably outdraw Tannen. But I don't.
Sandbag.
I can't reach it.
Okay, that means somehow over here I need to find a way to get the barrel.
Maybe we can come to a more peaceable solution, Mr. Tannen.
Keep your distance, Fancy Pants. I don't know you from Adam, but that won't stop me from putting you in a box next to your crazy girlfriend.
I'm not.
Rope? Nothing to click on here, nothing to click on here. Can't jump out here, I can't come out, I can't come out. Loose floorboard. Yes, there we go.
Okay, that was lucky.
Won't be long now.
We'll just see.
The ammo's in place. Now to pull the trigger.
Okay.
100 years from now, Hill Valley will erect a...
Right. Sure they will, Edna. Okay, come on. Just gotta get up. Figure this out. Come on, Marty.
The ammo's in place. Now to pull the trigger.
So jump on it! Sandbag. Pickle barrel.
That pickle juice will put the torch out for sure. Now to tip the barrel over.
Where is this rope located, Doc? Chandelier, shotgun, sandbag, pickle barrel. Not this rope. Is it this rope? Pull the rope. Not sure why I did that. See where the rope connecting the chandelier is. Hey, loose floorboard. Nothing. Okay.
The ammo's in place. Now to pull the trigger. The sandbag's right over Tannen's head. Hang in there, Doc. Dolores Miskin? I gotta find some way to snuff out Edna's torch without getting her and Doc killed. That pickle barrel's right over her head.
Okay. Here's the hard part. I gotta find a way to do this, which means hovering over everything. Edna, hey, loose floorboard, Doc, chandelier. Okay, there's nothing. Rope? Pulling that rope doesn't do anything, right?
What?
Okay, the ladder. No. Use it with the chandelier.
Not sure what that'll do.
Use it with the sandbag.
Not sure what that'll do.
Use it with the pickle barrel.
Not sure what that'll do. That pickle juice will put the torch out for sure. Now to tip the barrel over.
Right, I get it, Marty.
Come on.
Oh, okay.
Got any last words?
I'll see you in hell, Tannen.
You first, lady.
Come on, you son of a...
Ha! There we go!
The hell are you?
I'm the diversion, butthead.
Yes, Doc! Thank you!
Nice one, Doc.
Don't tell Claire. She thinks fisticuffs set a bad example for the boys. Now, where's Edna?
Oh, this is our Doc. Good.
She's gone. Edna's DeLorean.
We've got to stop her before she hits 88 miles per hour. Come on!
No more twists. No more turns. We have to end this here.
Okay, Edna, nothing to be worried about. You're a smart woman with a strong moral compass. You just need to think your way out of it. Oh, fudge!
What's she doing?
I think she's spouting euphemisms at us. Luckily, the road out of Hill Valley is still pretty rough in 1875. It's unlikely she'll manage to accelerate 88 miles an hour anytime soon.
How are we going to stop her?
Good question. We can't risk injuring her or damaging the vehicle for fear of altering the timeline even further. Luckily, those diagnostic lights my alternate self went all over her and Roy and have given me an idea. Here, take these.
What are these?
Flux signalization modules.
How do they work?
I generally use them for maintenance purposes. We might be able to use them to sync up with the alternate Roy's diagnostic modules, thus making it possible to link both sets of time circuits and override the time destination of the alternate DeLorean. At least that's the theory, anyway.
That's a great plan, I think.
Best of all, we won't need to weld the modules to the frame. We can snap them over the diagnostic lights.
Wait a minute, Doc. You want me to go out there? How the heck am I supposed to do that?
Good question. Let me think.
Aha! A hoverboard!
It saved our hides a few times before, so it seemed like the appropriate tool to bring along for the job.
Wow!
Sweet!
Oh my god, this is so cool!
You okay?
It's just like riding a bike.
You ready to make the jump?
Ready, Doc.
One, two, three, jump!
Oh, this is so cool.
Nice form, buddy. Out of reception on the wireless.
Great. Where'd you get these?
From Burns Cache of 21st Century Video Game Consoles. Now remember, all you've got to do is attach the flux sync modules to those diagnostic lights.
Will do, Doc. But it's getting a little bumpy out here.
Not the windshield wiper.
Whoa!
Okay.
I can't talk to her from here.
Whoa! Okay. Using the keyboard. Got it. Let's make sure. Okay, enter. Done. Got it.
Hey, that's one flux sync down. Two to go.
Two? Oh, the flux
sync. Is that one of the flux emitters?
Yes. Now plug in the flux sync.
Shit.
Sure what that'll do.
Let's go to the rear bumper. Can I grab onto Mr. Fusion? Mr. Fusion!
Mr. Fusion! Should I disable it?
Leave it alone! It's not a good idea to monkey with nuclear reactors.
Yeah, don't fool it. Okay. Grab onto that.
It's one of the flux emitters!
Okay.
From here. Not sure what that'll do.
Okay.
Oh, get off!
can't sneak past the rearview mirror. Not sure what that'll do.
No? Okay, good.
Get off!
For those of you who have been diligent watchers, this is very similar to the way the first chapter ended. Okay. Oh, perfect, perfect, perfect.
Mr. Fusion's belching flame.
Yes, that's unfortunate. I'd stay out of it if I were you.
Great.
Don't cross those flames, they may be radioactive.
Oh, shit.
It's like crossing through normal flames.
Oh, I know what to do. I know what to do. We should work with Mr. Fusion. There we go. Okay, good. Round. Up to the front, Marty. Come on. Here we go.
Made it.
Now let's get that function to fly much more before she starts making life difficult.
Okay.
She's been making it easy up till now?
Here we go. You got this.
There goes nothing, Doc. Whoa!
Perfect! Now, aim the fuck sink towards the receiving dish on my DeLorean.
Receiving dish. Check!
Okay, here we go. Here we go. Stay. Stay long enough. Yes! One more to go.
They're
how the fuck am I gonna do it?
There's one fuck thing left!
Get off my car, you hooligan!
Can I talk to Edna?
Edna!
What?
Let me in!
You want in? Fine!
Perfect! Oh, shit.
Marty! Are you alright?
Not really.
What?
Pull over!
No!
You're in a lot of danger!
So are you!
What that'll do.
There we go.
Marty, now that you're on top of the DeLorean, you can attach the flux sink to the overhead flux emitter.
It's great, Doc.
Yeah, no shit, Doc. Here we go.
Nicely done. Now, aim the sink toward the receiving dish.
Okay, we got it. Shit, okay. Stay. Oh, fuck, this is a hard one. Oh, God, this is hard! This is not easy! Stay! Come on, please, stay! Yes!
That's it! Get out of there, buddy!
Phew.
Okay, come on. What's next?
Now what?
Now we take control of that destroyer of the flux synchronizers, and that's strange.
Oh, don't tell me what's strange.
According to these readings, the temporal cohesion of Edna's DeLorean is decaying at an alarming rate.
English, Doc.
We've got to get Edna home, now.
Then I must be back in... Would you be kind enough to tell me what day it is?
It's the day I place you under arrest for arson, resisting arrest, and being a general all-round pain in the ass.
No! You can't arrest me! Not now, I just got back from the last century.
Would you look at that? Edna Strickland, drunk as a skunk.
I'm not drunk, you reprobate. I'm a time traveler.
Sure you are. I'm loving this.
I'll prove it to you. Come with me. We can do the whole day over if you want. We can fix everything.
We can start by drying you out. Come on, into the station with you.
You can bunk with me, doll.
I'd rather die. Stop it! Unhand me, you dolt!
Holy
well,
crow.
I guess that's it for Edna.
Yes, I suppose it is. You know, whoever said time heals all wounds didn't know squat about time travel.
What do we do about that, DeLorean?
No need to do a thing. Ever since we synced up the time circuits, the temporal breakdown in Edna's DeLorean has accelerated at an exponential rate. By my calculations, the timeline should catch up with it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, now!
What the hell? Hey, Parker, you're not gonna believe this!
See? What did I say? Ready to go home?
Wait, Doc, the timeline's not fixed yet. Look! Michael, you missed all the fireworks at the expo. Yeah, so I heard. Listen, I heard a rumor about you two.
I guess we gotta come clean. Ta-da! Marty took me to Reno last night.
Try to keep a secret in Hill Valley.
Well, you gonna congratulate us or what?
Then it's true. My grandpa's married the wrong grandma. I'm done for.
Hey, are you feeling all right, kid? You don't look so hot.
Marty, you can't do this. You're not supposed to get married for another 5 years.
Well, I know Trixie and I were taking things slow.
But after that witch Edna got me fired with that postcard, we kind of accelerated things a little.
The postcard? Oh, man. This just isn't right.
Now, I know marrying a Canadian for a work permit isn't strictly by the book, but hey, sometimes you gotta go out on a limb for the ones you love.
Isn't he just the sweetest?
Can you see through me?
Nope, never could figure you out. I thought you'd be thrilled for us.
You don't understand. You're supposed to marry Sylvia Miskin.
But I did marry Sylvia Miskin.
What?
You didn't think my real name was Trixie Trotta, did ya?
Don't feel too bad. It was kind of a surprise to me, too.
Wait a minute. You're Grandma Sylvie?
Grandma? Hey, how old do you think I am, kiddo?
But you're so... so skinny and blonde and...
Huh. Yeah, you know, it's amazing what
oh my God.
Like you as she'll a do for
I've
you.
Seen you naked. You're Sylvia?
You okay, pal?
Yeah, I'm fine. Great. You kids go off and have yourself a wonderful honeymoon. And don't worry about your dad, Artie. I'm sure he'll come around. Come around to what? To approving your marriage. You seem kind of mad about it back at the high school.
Well, that was before I got a look at her. Besides, as my dear old father Seamus used to say, no sense in getting riled up over something I can't do nothing about. And honestly, now that I met her, I can't imagine a better daughter-in-law than the charming Miss Sylvie here.
Aw, thank you, Dad.
As for you, stranger, I'll thank you to not go poking your nose in McFly family business.
It's been a pleasure, Agent Corleone.
See you in the funny papers, Mikey.
Goodbye, Grandma.
Heavens.
You know, I took some pictures of Trixie in 1931.
Hey, that's my grandma you're talking about.
The way things wrap themselves up. Although I knew that she was going to end up being Sylvia. I had a feeling. But wow. It really did all tie together.
Here we are, back in good old 1986.
May 14th?
15th. Best to build in a little lag time. Gives you a chance to catch up.
Looks like the estate sale is still going on.
Hey, don't you want to stay, Doc? You gotta stop the bank from selling off all your old stuff.
What are you talking about? Estate sale? Bank? I'm not dead, Marty. Clara and I are having a little garage sale, that's all.
Garage sale? You mean... Marty, you're back from your trip. Hello, Doc. Selling off the family treasures, eh?
Not quite, but I hope you find something you like.
Speaking of which, did you find what you were looking for?
Yeah, I sure did.
Great! Hey, is that a box of Asimov? Let me get this straight. Are you telling me you live here now? In 1986?
Well, naturally. Claire and I maintain a part-time residence here. Wasn't that the case when you left?
No.
Strange. I can't imagine not sticking around. After all, I've got my late father's foundation to supervise. If I wasn't here, who'd present the annual Earhart Brown Scholarship for Young Scientists? Something funny?
I'll explain it to you later.
I don't see what's so funny about looking after a family legacy. Oh, almost forgot. I've got something for you. Happy graduation.
Graduation? But that's not for another... The McFlys of Hill Valley.
An exhaustively detailed history of your family. From your great-great-grandfather Seamus to the present.
You traveled through time to write this?
Well, most of the research was done traditionally, but your grandma Sylvia proved to be something of a mystery.
Which is why you traveled back to 1931, to look for her.
Exactly. Who knew she was singing in a speakeasy under a stage name?
That's why he
this
went
is great,
Doc.
Thanks.
It's the least I can do for the man who saved me from making the worst mistake of my life.
Yoo-hoo! Dr. Brown!
Edna? Einie!
What's going on? What are you doing with my dog?
The same thing I do every afternoon, silly man. Giving him such much-needed exercise. Isn't that right, Einstein?
Hey, Dollface, it's past time for our 3:30.
Coming, sweetie! Oh, Mr. McFly, have you seen my stepson anywhere?
What?
Oh, Biff! I think you're late for an appointment.
Oh, gosh. You're right, Mr. McFly. Bye, Marty.
Don't they make a great little family? You'd never know they met in prison.
Don't say anything. Let's just walk quietly into the lab and hope there are no more surprises.
Okay, I'll take it. Oh, shit, now what?
Doc!
Marty! What are you doing here?
You gotta come with me! Back to the future!
Marty, you can't be here! If your younger self sees you, the consequences could be catastrophic!
My younger self? Oh, right! Bring him along, too! This concerns all of us!
What do you mean? Does something happen to us?
Do we turn into assholes or something?
Nah, we're fine. But our great-great-grandkids?
What the hell?
What? Great Scott. The fuck?
Doc, you gotta come back with me. Listen to him, Doc. It's me you gotta help. If you want to save Jennifer and our 12 kids.
What?
That timeline was overwritten 5 jumps back.
Doc,
Jennifer's out of
how can there be 2 more of me here?
I have no idea. My all rights of space-time continuum should be tearing apart like a cheap dish rag right now.
It already is. What my evil twin and I are trying to say is the future is totally jacked up.
What the fuck?
Come with me to save it. No, me.
So, we meet at last. You've altered my timeline once too often.
What's going on, Doc?
Well, we do seem to have a conundrum on our hands, or 3.
Yeah, Doc, but which one is the real me?
Isn't it obvious, Marty? Come on!
Prepare to be erased. Doc, wait! What about the space-time continuum?
Yeah, what about my future?
And mine?
The future can wait. We've got a present to catch up with.
Where to, Doc?
Mr. McFly, thrill me.
Wow. I wish I had face cam so you could just see the huge grin on my face right now. That was fantastic. That was absolutely fantastic. Wow, just that whole experience from point one to the end was just fantastic. I made it through, not a single walkthrough. The story was great. It absolutely kept me held the entire time. Every cliffhanger was absolutely fantastic. If anything, there were only a couple of bugs here and there that marred the gameplay experience, but not enough to truly detract from it. Everything about this game was an absolutely masterful, respectful, beautiful piece of nostalgia that both took what was laid before with the films and then built upon it and gladly took risks. Absolutely fantastic gameplay experience. Look, Marty Future performed by Michael J. Fox. Fantastic. 110% fantastic. I really don't remember the last time I was this satisfied at the end of a game. It's beautiful. Anyways, this is Chris of the California Kings. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope that you have enjoyed watching this video series, this Let's Play. I hope that it's inspired you to go out and purchase a game for yourself and experience it for yourself, because it's absolutely worth it. I don't think that there's going to be any end credits, anything past the end credits, but I'm just going to keep recording if it does. But I will cut out here if there is nothing after the credits. In fact, there probably is. Look, here we go. The credits are about to end. And this is just, wow. I literally have no words. That whole lack of words from me as soon as the DeLorean flew into the camera was just a big fucking grin on my face. I think I would probably rate this a 9 out of 10. You know, a couple technical glitches and a couple of, like, you know, a couple of moments that probably kept it from being a truly classic 10 out of 10 experience. All things concerned, though, this is a fantastic. Probably one of the best gameplay experiences I have had. in a very long time. Wow, just, that made me so happy. Made me so happy. And, so thank you so much. What? What? Oh, they probably just threw that in there for nostalgia purposes. Oh my god, from point A to point Z, that was just a beautiful game. That was an absolutely beautiful game, and thank you all so much for joining me on this journey. I'm gonna go, and I have had so much fun with this game. I'm gonna thank my brother Sean, King Sean of the California Kings. He was the one who bought this for me as a Christmas present, and it's been my absolute pleasure to be playing it for you, presenting this Let's Play for you folks. This has just been absolutely magnificent and wonderful, and it's just all things considered, this has just been a beautiful. I'm out of words. 9 out of 10. Great, fantastic gameplay experience. Here we go. So, please like, comment, subscribe. Check out everything else we got going on the California Kings channel. I'm not sure what I'm going to be picking up next, but I'll leave that as a surprise. It'll be a surprise to even myself, but it certainly will have a hard time topping this. We'll see you next time on whatever else I end up playing. And you know what? In all honesty, if you are a fan of Back to the Future, even in the slightest, you deserve it to yourself to go pick up this game and experience it for yourself. So, until we meet again, loyal subjects, this is Chris, Idaho Jack on Steam, and I bid you adieu.